Good morning, everyone. Welcome back to Anchala Vidyaniketan Kudige. I'm your science teacher, Mrs. Josney Jose, and I'm here today with a new chapter, that is fiber to fabric.
Fibers are the thinner strands which are derived from the plants and animals. These fibers are then twisted together to make yarn, and yarn are bonded together to make the fabric.
History of clothing material. Have you ever wondered what materials people used in ancient times for clothes? It appears that in those times, people used the bark and the big leaves of trees or animal skins and furs to cover themselves. After people began to settle in agriculture communities, they learned to weave twigs and grasses into mats and baskets. Vines, animal fleece were twisted together into long strands. These were woven into fabrics. The early Indians wore fabrics that are made out of cotton that grew in the regions near to the river Ganga. Fibers are divided into two types. They are natural fibers and synthetic fibers. The fibers of some fabrics such as cotton, jute, silk and wool are obtained from plants and animals. These are called natural fibers. Cotton and jute are examples of fibers that are obtained from plants, and wool, silk fibers are obtained from animals. Fibers are also made from chemical substances which are not obtained from plant or animal sources. These are called synthetic fibers. Some examples are polyester, nylon. Let's learn about plant fiber, cotton. Cotton plants are usually grown at places having black soil and warm climate. The fruits of the cotton plant are about the size of lemon. After maturing, the bolls burst open and the seeds covered with the cotton fibers can be seen. At that time, the cotton bolls are collected using machine. The process of collecting cotton from the bolls is known as picking, which is done using the machine. Cotton fibers are then separated from seeds by the process of ginning. Ginning was traditionally done by hand. These days, machines are also used for ginning. The process of making yarn from fibers is called spinning. In this process, fibers from a mass of cotton wool are drawn and twisted. This brings the fibers together to form a yarn. A simple device used for spinning is a hand spindle, also called takli. Another hand operated device used for spinning is charkha. Use of charkha was popularized by Mahatma Gandhi as a part of the independence movement. Spinning of yarn on a large scale is done with the help of spinning machines. After spinning, yarns are used to make fabrics. Yarns to fabric. There are many ways by which fabrics are made from yarns. The process of arranging two sets of yarns together to make a fabric is called weaving. The two sets of yarn are woven to make a fabric. The yarns are much thinner. Weaving of fabric is done on looms. The looms are either hand operated or power operated. Next process is knitting. In knitting, a single yarn is used to make a piece of fabric. Single yarn gets pulled out continuously as the fabric gets unraveled. Knitting is done by hand and also on machines. Weaving and knitting are used for making different kinds of fabric. These fabrics are used for variety of clothing items. Cotton rolls by ginning is converted into fiber. These cotton fibers on spinning made into yarn. Through knitting or weaving, yarns are converted to produce the fabric. Then the fabrics are used to make a different varieties of cotton clothes. Jute are the another plant fiber which is obtained from the stem of the jute plant. It is cultivated during the rainy season. In India, jute mainly grown in West Bengal, Bihar and Assam. The jute plant is normally harvested when it is at the flowering stage. The stem of the harvested plants are immersed in water for few days. The stems, root and fibers are separated by hand. To make fabric, all these fibers are first converted into yarn. Then, by spinning or weaving, these are converted into fabric. So I hope you all have enjoyed by watching this video. Thank you, children. Have a nice day.